Hi everyone, I'm Cody, W3AMG with BridgeCom Systems, and today we're going to be showing you how to set up your radio to have multiple users or multiple DMR IDs. So it's actually really simple. All we're going to do is jump in here on the software. So go ahead and plug in your radio to your computer. So plug one side in the computer, other side into the side of your radio, just like that. And over here on the computer, first thing you want to do is read from the radio. So, just go to the COM port, make sure it shows up there, which it does, and then click the button to the left of that read from radio. And we'll just read the other data. Awesome, there we have it. So you wanna go down here to the digital tab, open that digital tab up, and then click on radio ID list right here. Now this is the list of people who are actually using the radio. In this case, we have myself, but I could very easily add another one here. We'll give it a DMR ID. Obviously you put the DMR ID in there and then give it a name. There we go. So we have another user now. At this point, all you'll have to do is click the COM port button. There we go. And click write to radio. Go ahead and write the other data, and we'll be all set. Awesome, so on our radio, if we want to actually change our radio ID to talk as a different person, what you'll wanna do is probably use a VFO. If you're using your main code plug, that is gonna be set up for that one user. So if you wanna switch that to a different ID, you'll actually have to do that for each channel, which you may not wanna do. So I'd recommend just go to your VFO and click on menu, we'll go down to settings, and go to channel set, and we're gonna scroll down here to radio ID. There you go. Click on that, and now you can see there is my current one, and here is the test 123 that we just created. So you can click on that, click on option, and then at that point you have some options there. If you'd like, you can actually add more here in this section as well, and in this case we can select the radio ID and that will select it as our current user. There we go.